starring June Lockhart, Hugh Riley, John Provost as Timmy, and, of course, Lassie.
You know you shouldn't be running around at a time like this.
She doesn't act as though she's very happy.
That's how they always act, when they're ready to lamb, Mom.
Oh. Well, I'd say to be here by noon tomorrow at the very latest. What is it?
Listen. There it is. It's a chopper.
A what?
A chopper. That's what they call helicopters. He's going to land.
Yes, I think he is.
Can Lassie, may Lassie and I go see Mom? Thanks, Mom. Come on, girl.
Timmy?
I know, Mom. I'll be careful.
Hi.
What you doing?
Loading a cedar.
Loading a cedar?
Yeah. You see those burned-out hills over there? I'm reseeding them. I put the seeds in this hopper here, and then I control the spreader down there from the cockpit. These are annual rye and mustard seeds. They form a good, strong root system that holds the water.
All us farmers know you have to have a good watershed.
That's right. Good boy. Matter of fact, this county's doing a pretty good job. I'll be up here reseeding for maybe another 3 days.
This is my dog, Lassie. My name's Timmy Martin.
No kidding. It's my name, too.
Is your name Timmy Martin?
No, just Martin. You can call me Chuck.
Okay, Chuck. Were you a pilot in the Army? While the war was going.
Well, yeah, me and about 10,000 other guys.
Did you shoot down any enemy planes?
You're running true to form, Timmy. That's the first question every boy asks.
Well, did you?
I hate to disappoint you, but the answer is no.
Oh.
Here, would you hold these for me?
Sure. Do you ever give people free rides in that chopper?
I'm afraid I'd have to get special permission to give you a ride in this old chopper.
Oh. What would you do if you got in trouble?
What kind of trouble is that? You mean like getting lost or something?
Yeah.
Well, I guess I'd call for help.
I know. S.O.S.
Yeah, something like that. Except we call it Mayday.
Mayday?
Mm-hmm. It's the international call for distress. It comes from a French expression meaning help me.
No.
Well, now, if you put those sacks in the truck for me and take your dog over there and sit on a rock, I'll be able to take off, huh?
Okay. Come on, Lassie. Is going to be a helicopter.
I think your friend Chuck must have made a pretty big impression on you.
Pilots have to have a lot of courage, Mom. It takes a lot of nerve to fly.
Oh, yes, I agree. But there have been other men of great bravery, too.
I'm thinking of missiles and rockets to the moon and things like that. I've been reading about Captain Eddie Rickenbacker. Listen to this part, Lassie. Eddie Rickenbacker was not a racer before he joined the Army. Then he became one of the greatest fighter pilots in the American forces.
I think that perhaps Lassie'd be more interested in a story about heroic war dogs.
That's a good idea.
Well, it'll have to wait until tomorrow. Come on now. It's way past your bedtime.
Okay, Mom.
Ah!
What's the matter, Lassie?
She may be in trouble.
Don't worry, Mom. Lassie will pick up her scent.
Timmy, you follow Lassie. I'll take the pickup and go down the road and see if I can spot her.
Okay. Go as far as the main highway. Then come back here. If we find her, I'll send Lassie. And I'll stay with you.
Please be quiet.
Mom, listen. There he is.
It's gone.
He'll be back. He's receding these hills. But he'll be too high up to see us.
Well, now, don't worry, Timmy. I'll think of something.
Well, you better think of it fast.
I'll build a fire. Oh, with what?
Use gasoline. Dad always carries a spare tank.
Thank you.
a mayday, Mom.
A what?
It's a distress call. Spell out mayday. He'll recognize that.
Down.
My son is up there.
Well, how do you ever get up there?
Well, can you get him down?
Come on, let's take a look.
Chap! Chap, I'm up here!
What's the matter, Timmy? They got you stuck up there? I'm gonna need a rope.
Oh, well, there's one right here in the truck.
Enough? Yes, fine. Timmy, we're gonna get you down from there, but I have to have your help.
Okay, just tell me what you want me to do.
All right, I'm coming up there with a helicopter, but I can't get in close enough for you to hop into the cockpit, so I'm gonna tie a rope around the skid, and there'll be a loop on the end of it. I want you to put your leg through that loop. You got that?
Okay.
Now, when you grab hold of the rope and get your leg through the loop, you hold on tight. You understand? Hold on tight.
Yes, sir.
You all right, Sonny?
I'm fine. Thanks for getting me off of there.
I don't know if I can tell you how grateful I am.
Oh, forget it. I'm glad I was around. Say, we have one more job to do.
What's that?
Let's put out this fire before it spreads and does more damage to these hills.
I got just the thing of the doctor.
I guess that about does it.
Thank you again, very much.
I guess I better be getting back to work, too.
Thanks for me, too. I guess I gotta ride in a helicopter. Even if you didn't have special permission.
That you did, son, but you know, I sure don't recommend it.
So long.
So long.
Thank you.
Good luck to both of you.
Daddy, please.
Yes, he will indeed.
Look, Mom. I told you pilots were brave. Did you see the way he picked me off that ledge?
I think you were pretty brave, too.
Me, brave? I was scared to death.
Yes, I know you were.